I am Vaidya Subramaniam and presenting before you a very distinguished panel for an important topic for the post-lunch session. Is too much tech making young India uncreative? Yeah, Mr. Jairam again, you know, he comes with a unique hat. He comes from a different geography, from North America. So how have you maintained the connect sitting in North America, and you said you're trying to experiment something very unique. And if you can explain the uniqueness in your experimentation in 3 minutes, we would appreciate it.
Good evening. I'm very delightful to be here to participate in Think Education Conclave. I really appreciate the New Indian Express Prabhu Chawla to organize this kind of national events, and I'm very delighted to share the platform with all these extreme delegates from various fields. By saying that, I'm living in US for last 4 decades. Even though I live in US, by my heart and soul is in India. Because the way we raised, the way we born, even though we are abroad and we are staying in US also, our minds are set for India. We always think of how prosperous India is. I can throw a couple of examples. I went to US in 1980. My mode of communication to my parents is only a telegram. I don't know how many youth knows about the telegram. The telegram has disappeared from the planet. Then the second mode of communication is booking a trunk call. If you book a trunk call today, the call will be connected day after tomorrow. That is the situation even in US, the most forward country in the world. That was the situation. The topic today is the technology is demoralizing or deceiving the youth. I don't think so. In my opinion, we are living in a technological world. I live in San Francisco, where all the major companies, that is called Silicon Valley, more than 500,000 South Indians work in all this technology field. But how to use it is the one. For the youth, all we can say is, even in Andhra Pradesh, I hail from Andhra Pradesh, even in Andhra Pradesh, a 10th class student can create a website. A 10th class student can create an app. It means the technology can be used in many ways. Yes, there are some flaws. I have no doubt about it. Even a country like US, more than 400 million people, 300 million people own the gun. We don't see that much of a distraction of the gun. The gun is for the protection of the people. If you use properly, you won't have any problem. The same way technology also, it is a way of life. But we have to adopt the new technologies. I can tell you, one day in the entire Silicon Valley, all the Indians don't go to the work. Some systems will be stopped. Don't you proud that we have more than 4 million people living in US compared to any American, any national, any Chinese, any Thailands, number two in the country competing with Jews. The highest average income for Indians among US, all based on the technology. Technology is not at all bad. How you use it? Yes, for the youth, young India, use it for good.
So proper,
that is the way we need to address that.
So you're an advocate of proper use. Yes. That's the bottom line.
Yes, sir.
So two catchwords in the topic, too much and uncreative. So
I'd like to add on this.
1 minute, let me just quickly finish this as a question and then take it for open discussion, sir. Too much and uncreative. How much to preserve native creativity? If all of you can just quickly answer this question and then we'll throw it open. How much? To protect native creativity, because everybody is of the opinion, everybody individual has creativity in their own rights, and how much is optimum? If you want to start from there, yeah, you can begin.
Yeah. I'm representing the government of Andhra Pradesh as a special representative in North America. My goal is to bring the NRIs and their attention towards their motherland and to serve the community better. In that, we called AP Janmabhoomi, Andhra Pradesh Janmabhoomi, under that flagship. We were able to digitalize all the government schools across the state. So far, we were able to do 3,600 schools, digital classrooms in each high school. From the early stage, the kid will have an access to. Now the whole world is in our fingertips. If you don't have to ask anybody, you ask a Google uncle, he'll give you all the information on the panelist's bio. But we need to adopt that kind of systems. And not only that, we need to improve it from the initial stages of a high school level. That's what our Honorable Chief Minister, first in the country, Andhra Pradesh has a special representative for NRIs. No other state will appoint an NRI. The reason behind it, a visionary leader like Chandrababu, he thought of, there are almost 500,000 Telugus living in America. We need to absorb their talent. We need to absorb their resources. We need to absorb their investments. On that purpose, he created a cabinet post and he appointed me. I'm very grateful. On that note, we improve the school education in Andhra Pradesh. We have 5,200 high schools in entire Andhra Pradesh, 3,650 schools. So far with the NRI involvement, from the early stage, you need to give them the tools to be creative. Without the tool, you cannot be creative. So we are very happy on that part. The student, more than 1 million people got benefit out of it. And at the same time, the attendance increased, the level of understanding will increase, the content, but not only NRI is donating the money, but they are involved with the each and every school which they contributed.
So shall I say the scope of your work is to support government functions? To that extent, you're able to quantify the scope of technology being used to support government functions,
support government,
more importantly in school education.
Yes, support government, yeah, and at the same time NRI involvement in that.
Correct. Of course, the Indian diaspora is, yes, what you're representing, yes, today. Yeah. With that note of confidence, I'll bring this session to a close. No more questions. We are technology connected. You can shoot questions over email later. Thank you very much, panel, and sorry for cutting it short.